We've been waiting to find out what it is that warranted the FBI going to Mar-a-Lago and raiding it. And the right wing was saying there's, I mean, it has to be something good. You have to tell us. So now it's about nukes. You would think, well, that's the end of that debate. I mean, if it's about nukes, then they have to take it semi-seriously. Come on, have you watched Fox News? Take a look at Laura Ingraham last night.
That FBI agents were scouring Trump's residence in search of nuclear documents. Now, that could mean anything, right? It could be a printout from the Nuclear Regulatory Agency or the Department of Energy. It could be an email, whatever. And if that's the excuse that they want to run with for this raid, how could they possibly justify letting Hillary Clinton off the hook when she was holding documents that were classified at the highest levels?
First of all, as I've always said, go investigate the server, investigate Hillary Clinton. I really don't care. I don't think they do either, because after all, she's pretending there that she wants an equal standard, which is if you have this stuff, you should be investigated. But bear in mind, she doesn't want Trump to be investigated. So if there is a standard, it's to not investigate either of them. So in that case, she could probably just calm down. But no, the fact that it's about nuclear weapons, it could be a brochure, it could be an email, it could be a recipe, it could be anything. Well, it can't be anything, because many things are not about nuclear weapons, which this thing is. So that does narrow it down just a little bit, Laura Ingraham. But of course, that's their job, Brett. I mean, come on. There was nothing that was going to be in this thing where they're going to be like, oh, they're serious now. Now S got serious. No, it was never going to happen.
It's so funny how low the bar is for like creating a segment on Fox News. They're just like, yeah, it could be, you know, anything. I think the most hilarious concept would be if in the White House, in the like Oval Office secret bathroom, they actually write the nuclear codes under an ashtray, and Trump was just stealing souvenirs and he accidentally stole that ashtray, and they're like, yeah. And everybody's embarrassed. I love the whataboutism. TYT members, viewers, everybody doesn't have to worry about that whataboutism, because TYT always calls out, like, if there is injustice in the system carried out by the elites, first off, no surprise there. Second off, I want it investigated no matter what. If it's Obama, if it's Carter, if it's JFK, if it's FDR, yeah, investigate it. The people, the weirdness is the double standard on the people who are telling you that there's a double standard, and that's Fox News. People like Laura Ingraham who are like, but what about Hillary Clinton? It's like they always talked about Hillary Clinton. That was nonstop nonsense.
100%. Yeah, we're actually later on the show, we're going to go into just a little bit of how much. But so that was Laura Ingraham. Sean Hannity says the documents are meaningless. So it's not even that it could be anything, they're literally meaningless. How does he know? He doesn't know, but they're meaningless.
And regarding those droids, these aren't the ones you're looking for, said
clearly. Exactly. But look, this is part of a pattern. I want to show you just two more quick videos, because they have been like Donald Trump. He loves to attack his enemies, but he also loves to, whether intentionally or not, humiliate his allies. And when he continually lies and makes people go out and say his lies, and then it's revealed that they're lies because he's not even smart enough to hide the lies well, then they inevitably and almost instantaneously look like idiots as a result of it. And so they were running with all week. You're saying he should release it, but he can't release it. Okay, how could he possibly release it? He doesn't have it. Well, he did have it, which led to this fun back and forth on the five.
See, if I'm willing to do that, some people have got to be willing to say the president had the warrant and he had the receipt and he said he didn't.
It's not about that.
That's not a crime.
It's not about the warrant, and you know it. It's not about the warrant.
We're talking abuse of power.
Yes, we are very much talking about abuse of power, Jeanine Pirro. You just seem to be missing who's doing the abusing. And you're right. It's not a crime to say you don't have it. It's a lie to say that you don't have it. And when you've identified that the guy you worship lied to you, we were never going to believe it, but you did. He lied to you. You might ask the follow-up question, wait, why was he lying about that? If this is the thing that he says and you still say will exonerate him, why was he lying about not having it? And now you know he does have it, so why is he not releasing it? These are fascinating questions. They would make for good discussion on a show like The Five.
These fools. when Jeanine Pirro goes home and takes off her wig and her makeup and her fake teeth, and Jesse Waters goes home and just like pulls off his wig and his mask and his stupid, he like, remember when the Joker like wiped off the makeup and he revealed that he had white face underneath? When he does, when they all do that, they all go like, this is so exhausting at the end of the day. And they were and as much as they say that on the left, like, oh, people in Hollywood can't say that they have questions about certain things because they're afraid they'll get canceled. That's exactly what happens on the five. Yes. There are things that these free speech warriors say you cannot, that they cannot say without themselves literally getting canceled from shows like The Five. They're all begging that Ron DeSantis' spy at Mar-a-Lago's plan totally worked out. And this vanquishes Trump from everyone's world once and for all. Because they're at this point willing to go back to like lower ratings and boringer news just so they don't have to debase themselves so frequently on national television.
You're 100% right. There's things you just can't say. They're politically incorrect, one would say. What Harold Ford Jr. just said there was incorrect and they had to shut him down. This is actually a pattern though. I'm gonna show one more video. Sorry, Sophie. Let's go to this. This is from the previous day on The Five. Take a look at Jeanine Pirro, who I'm gonna guess was 2.5 bottles in. Here's how she responds to an inconvenient fact being presented to her.
Of what?
Actually just did something really bad and he shouldn't have done it. You have 15 boxes carted away already, 10 to 12 this time around.
He cooperated with them.
No, he didn't. That's how
he cooperated with them.
Yelling it doesn't make it true.
Yeah, he did.
Jesse, tonight on your show, can you please add Sandy Berger?
I love when they He cooperated with him. How dare you?
I'll tell you, like, as yeah. It's so ridiculous. And it's so
really fast, Brett. Factually, he did not cooperate. He kept many boxes. Jeanine, don't throw a bottle at me. Don't throw the bottle, but he did not cooperate.
A bottle of what? Like pills, booze.
I like to think that she has a cocktail. The Jeanine Pirro sort of quasi boba cocktail. It's wine. Yeah. It's not boba floating in it, but it's a mix of pills. I don't
know. She's got one of those giant straws where she's like, ooh, the tapioca zannies are hitting pretty good today.
Oh my god. Anyway, look, that's insensitive of us to say, except look at what she's presenting us with. That was live on TV. That's how she comports herself. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.